हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आई एच के सिन्हा योर इंग्लिश टीचर अगेन प्रेजेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू टू डिलीवर द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर मॉडल। यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड द प्रीवियस टॉपिक अबाउट मे माइट कैन कुड एंड शुड। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द मॉडल। फर्स्टली you start here from shall. You will listen its use cautiously because there may be confusion in understanding you. Firstly, shall is used in future tense with first person singular plus plural. That means in first person singular and plural both for reflecting future idea you can use shall. For example, I shall go there.
ऐसे ना कुछ नहीं हो रहा।
Continue. For example, I shall go there tomorrow. Here you are saying the pronoun is I, which is in first person and singular number. Secondly, we shall go to Patna next month. Here you are saying as a subject, first person in plural form. So, in singular form of first person and plural form as we in first person, shall is used to reflect common future tense. Now, when certain programs comes, then with second person and third person, it also comes. For example, you shall come tomorrow. This sentence shows the definite case. In spite of second person, we are using here shall, and it determines the work. Second example, they shall return his money next month. Here is also third person plural number, but we are using shall because it shows determined work. Sure work is reflected here, so in spite of third person, we are using shall. Now come about will. In future tense, commonly it is used with second person and third person, singular plus plural. For example, you will go there tomorrow. They will ask a question from you. Here is second person you, here is third person they. In common cases, for second person and third person, we use will. But adversely, in a special case, when we want to show the certain duty, then in spite of second person and third person, we can use it with first person, singular and plural also. For example, you can see here, I will help you. Here, I will help you. Here is first person I, and will shows certain work. In the same way, we will leave this house. Here is determination also. In common case, for I and we have to use shall, but in a special case, to show the determined work, we use will both in both case. Now come to know about would. Would is the past of will. In present, in future, we use will word, but its past is would. For example, he told me that he would not return. Here, would is used because your tense is in past form. Told is in past form. So, the next clause is taking would. Second sentence, Sita told Rama that she would go to the jungle with him. Here your reporting verb is also in past tense. So in further case, in place of will, we are using would. Now second use. It is used to offer someone in future. Something in future also. For example, would you like to stay here? Would you like... Now third use of... would is in past conditional sentence. For example, if I were a bird, I would fly in the sky. और इफ आई वेर किंग आई वुड रूल ओवर द कंट्री वेल. फोर्थ यूज, इट्स यूज टू शो इरेगुलर ड्यूटी ऑफ पास्ट, नॉट रेगुलर ड्यूटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ही वुड कम हेयर सम टाइम व्हेन ही वॉज ए चाइल्ड, सी वुड गो देयर व्हेन सी वॉज 5 years ago. इट बोथ द सेंटेंसेज शोज द इरेगुलर ड्यूटीज. नाउ कम टू नो अबाउट यूज टू एंड यूज टू. फर्स्ट इज इन प्रेजेंट टेंस, सेकेंड इज इन पास्ट टेंस. इट शोज द रेगुलर ड्यूटी ऑफ एनी वर्क. फॉर रेगुलर प्रैक्टिस, आई यूज टू रीड द रामायण डेली और ही यूज टू गो देयर एवरी डे. नाउ नेक्स्ट यूज ऑफ मॉडल ऑट टू एंड मस्ट, बोथ आर सेम इन यूज. इट्स हिंदी इज अवश्य चाहिए. इट शोज कंपल्सन ड्यूटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू ऑट टू ऑबे द ट्रैफिक रूल, वी मस्ट पे इनकम टैक्स. नेक्स्ट मॉडल इज नीड और नीड नॉट. नीड एंड नीड नॉट बोथ आर यूज इन इंट्रोगेटिव और इन निगेटिव. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, नीड यू गो देयर और ही नीड नॉट गो देयर. आफ्टर नीड, थैंक यू वेरी मच. नाउ इन नेक्स्ट क्लास.